There's this one thing about terminals that's been bothering me for quite some time. Not big enough to fix, just annoying enough to notice. Here's what I mean. The text here goes right up against the edges of the terminal window. It's like it's trying to escape the screen or something. I found a quick fix that completely changed how the terminal feels to use, and I'm going to show you how to do it. Welcome to Nick's Tricks. I am Nick, and this is how you add padding to your terminal. How's it going, guys? It's been a while, again. I really wanted to share this because it's such a small tweak, but it makes a huge difference. It's super simple, it takes only a few seconds, and honestly, I wish I'd done this years ago. Padding is important when it comes to text. More and more UIs have been adopting this design trend with bigger elements, more spacing, and layouts that are more comfortable and relaxed. I wanted my terminal to do the same. Printed documents all have padding. Look at the tube on this bad boy from the 80s. Its padding is made of glass. This one is made of plastic. Whatever, visually it's still padding to me. So why should the text on my thin bezel monitor start all the way here? It really shouldn't, and we're gonna change that. So how do you change the padding in the terminal? Well, there are so many of them that it depends on the terminal. Some of them make it as easy and intuitive as changing a setting in the options. For example, in Konsole with a K from KDE, you can just edit your profile by first going to the Appearance tab, then the Miscellaneous tab, and under this Terminal Contents group, adjust the margins to the value that you want in pixels. As you do that, you can see its change in real time in the background. How cool is that? Others like Alacritty or Kitty, for example, allow you to set this value by editing their config files. For Alacritty, you need to edit or create a file if it doesn't already exist under .config/alacritty named alacritty.yaml or alacritty.toml. In my case, it's a YAML file because I'm using version 0.12 something something, but they switched the format to toml in 0.13. Just something to be aware of. In Kitty, if you press Ctrl+Shift+F2, it opens the config file directly so you can start editing right away. Once you're done, save and press Ctrl+Shift+F5 to just reload the config without having to close the terminal and reopen it. But what happens if your terminal doesn't expose this functionality in its settings? There are lots of terminals in the situation, Tilex for one, as well as GNOME Terminal, Quake, XFC, Terminal Terminator, and so on. I use Tilex and I love it. I've been using it every day since before it was even called Tilex. I can easily split vertically and horizontally, and navigate between panes, synchronize input, find text, and so on, but padding is not something you can customize directly. Luckily, what Tilex and all the other above have in common is a library called VTE, Virtual Terminal Emulator, which provides the GTK widget used to render text and handle input-output. Which means, like most GTK things, we can target it with a CSS selector and add a simple rule to use a custom padding value. To do this, you can go to .config/gtk3.0 or 4.0 if you're using a newer version, and find a file named gtk.css or create it if it doesn't exist. Add this very simple one-liner to it, set the custom amount of padding in pixels, and then save. Kill any open terminals and start a new session to see the changes. If you're blinking really fast, it's because your eyes are clapping with excitement right now. This, of course, applies to all VTE-compatible terminals you may be using. If I open a bunch of them, you'll notice that perfect padding consistently applied all across. You may not think this is a big deal right away, but it does hit different. Just give it a try, give it some time, and that's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and please consider booping that like button if you found this video helpful. If you're a longtime subscriber, thank you so much for sticking around, and if you're new here, welcome aboard and keep an eye out for more cool stuff coming up. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.